We wanted to welcome you today to our, I don't know why I called it a webinar. It is a webinar, but it's more of a training, live, so you get to see my beautiful face. We're excited today for the product that we're going to show. This is a product that's been, we've wanted to release for a while, but we wanted to make sure that we worked everything out and got it to where we feel that it's a reliable product and we're to that point. We're excited about it because, like most of the products that we show you on these webinars, this is a product that fits in a niche that we think is something that you guys can utilize and that you'll be able to go to jobs where they need specific things of this nature and say, yeah, I definitely have an option for it. What we're showing today is called our, this is our digital LR receiver. I think we call it something else too. What else do we call it, Melissa? Passability DLR, that's what we call it. I should have known that. I know how it works, I just don't know what it's called. So today we're gonna go over how it works. We're gonna show you some of the applications and explain to you the differences in this product and some of the other ones out there. I can tell you first and foremost that what you're gonna see and how this operates, you'll think to yourself, oh, that's a lot. That's very similar to a UHF reader, or that's similar to some other active tag systems that I know of. One of the great things about ours is the price point, and I talk about that every time we do a training. The price point on the receiver, it is very inexpensive for what it does and the features that it offers, and then the tags are inexpensive compared to most. Now, this is a system and an application that is specific, and I'm going to explain that to you. So if you look up here and pay no attention to the wiring whatsoever, we'll blame it on a new guy that works here. This is a new guy that wired this up, not me. I wired it up in a hurry, okay? So I know it's not perfect and it doesn't look great, but that's okay. So this is the receiver. What the receiver does is the receiver allows you to dial in the range that you want the active tags to be read at and the duration of time before they're read again. And we're going to go through all these functionalities and features when we go over to the manual, but I wanted to show you how this looks like. You have an LED indicator that indicates power. This light will change color when you present a transmitter to it. Depending on if it's the transmitter that's valid at the time, it will go invalid as red, valid as green. So you have some indication that shows you exactly what's happening. You have, you'll see here your inputs for power. This is a certified power wire installation here. But you've got 12 or 24 volt AC, DC. You have one relay, which we'll show you here in a minute. So you have your common, normally open, and normally closed. And then you also have an input for Wigan. This system can be both standalone and Wigan. That's a pretty big deal for this. So if you're on a job where they have an access control system, you can set this with a jumper to output Wigan 26-bit and it will act just like a card reader. The transmitters have facility codes and serial numbers on them that will pass through to your access control system, and then the management of those access control systems is done in the software that you're using. Or if you're on a job where access control is not available, this can be put in standalone mode where you individually save the transmitters into the receiver, and then when an active transmitter is showed, it's just going to trigger the relay that's on our board. You can have up to 100 transmitters saved in the standalone mode. Wigan mode, you can have as many as your access control system allows you to. So those two features alone allow you to go on everything from a really good size installation down to a small installation where they just need standalone, which is nice. We have tested in both environments. Both the standalone and the Wigan work great. The Wigan, like I said, passes through the facility code and the serial number, and then it's up to your access control system to determine what it wants to do from there. Application for this product. I know the first thing guys are going to ask is, will it work in cars? I'm going to give you a big, I don't even know the word, big warning right now. We did test it in cars. We have tested in cars. It was a small sample size, but it has been tested. It worked well, I can tell you that. It missed a couple of reads, and I'll show you what I mean by that, missing some reads and then picking up. But we tested it in high-end cars and then low-end cars, and it did work. Now, do I think this is a replacement for UHF readers? I don't. I think UHF readers are much more reliable. But this is a good application if, I would say smaller applications with cars you could use it on, but we did test it and it worked. We were getting about 40 to 45 feet of range with our tag inside the car hanging from the rear view mirror, okay? That's how we tested it. Again, that was tested in a high-end car and then just standard cars, and it worked well. The best application, the application that we really want to sell this for, is to be on a person. So if you have a person who is coming towards the door, You would put your receiver here. You're going to dial in the range that you want it to read that tag. As soon as you get within that range, it's going to trigger the door. I'm going to step outside real quick and grab a tag. I couldn't keep it in here because it kept triggering the door. So the tags that we use, I'll get back here on camera. The tags that we use, you can see that I just triggered the door, are our Firefly housings. Okay, these are an active tag. And you can see on the back, I don't know if we can see that, Melissa. Can we see that? Kind of. You can see that there is a facility code and a serial number on the back of that transmitter, okay, if you need to use it for a Wigan. And then there's a battery inside this. This is an active tag. It transmits every 3 seconds. You can see I continue to open the door, and if you look up here, you can see that the light is blue, and then when it reads my tag again, it will go green, okay? So I have this set to a certain timer, so it will only read a certain amount of times. But you'll see when those tags, it just went green again, and it's gone green again, and it's opening that door, okay? So that means a valid read. I have this one, this certain application, is in Wigan mode. So we have it connected to our access control panel, and the access control panel is the system that's determining if this door opens or closes. And you can see I continue to open this door. So let's go ahead and jump to the manual so I can show you the differences and the functions that you have and the way that you can set these settings. Because the application for this, if you picture handicap access, or we had an application with an underground parking lot where they just wanted their residents to be able to walk toward the door and have that door unlock, this is the exact application for that. You can have the transmitter in your pocket. It's been tested in your pocket. You can wear it in the lanyard, and then when you approach the door and get within the range, then that door is going to trigger and that door is going to open. So it does not have to be on an automatic door opener like we've shown here. This is just an application, so it's a little bit more visual when we're doing this webinar. But you can put it on a gate operator, a man gate, an electric strike, a mag lock, any of these things will work, and it's simply just going to trigger that either through the relay on the access control panel or the relay built into our board if you're in standalone mode. And you can see I continue to trigger this door after the amount of time that I've set. So let's jump to the manual and I'll show you how this works. Again, everything we show, and I'm going to put these transmitters back outside or else they're going to keep reading. Everything we show is always found on our website with manuals that are up to date. I'm on our website, transmittersolutions.com. This is going to be found under the receiver section. And then if I scroll down, you'll see here. And again, we use this housing on a lot of different products, our High 500. So it's a housing that you should be familiar with. And then the Passability DLR, which you see here. This is a watertight housing. It comes with a watertight lid and all the mounting hardware that you need. So that's kind of nice. And then we have our transmitter there as well. So if I go to downloads in the manual, I'd click on that, or we have the cut sheet. I've got the manual pulled up. This is a 12 or 24 volt AC or DC system. It's using 433 megahertz. That's the transmission that we're using. And again, it can be standalone mode or Wigan mode. The Wigan will output 26-bit Wigan. Here's a picture of our board. This is where you're going to make any adjustments that you need. So you have two dials at the top, and Melissa maybe will show the actual receiver. You have two dials. You have the T1 here and the T2. These are just changed with a little screwdriver. You can change them, and I'm going to have you jump back to the manual, sorry. These are where you're going to change the range and the delay time. So T1 allows you to adjust from 0, which is the furthest range, up to, I believe it's 9, which is the shortest range, and I'll get you to a breakdown here. And we have it in meters, but I can break that down for you. So if you're set to 0 on the T1, your tag is going to read at 20 meters or 60 feet. We will do the conversion. 60 feet, and then you can get it all the way down to, if you set the position on the T1 to 9, you're going to be at 1 meter, which is 3 feet. So you can see you have a lot of variation here in the range that you can do. Now, max range in open space is about 150 feet. That is not in a car. That is optimal open space range of 150 feet. Like I said, in a car, we had our position set to 0, which is the maximum range, and we were getting about 30 to 45 feet, depending, okay? But you can set that range. So I could say, oh, I have a certain application where they're going to be approaching a door. I only want that door to trigger at 10 feet. That way, by the time they get to the door, that door is still unlocked. 1 meter or 3 feet is a little bit short, because by the time they get within range and it reads and triggers a relay, they may have to wait a little while. We found, in our testing, we found the best settings are between 4 and 5 for an application where you're walking towards a door. We tested it on a door here. We've been testing it on this mini door, and the best setting we found for when it's on a person is position 4 or position 5, which is going to get you between 8 to 12 feet. Okay, so that's T1. T2 is an adjustment for, and I'm just going to get us back to the picture of the board, the delay. What this means, and what you saw on our door, is that when I approach the door and I get within the range, let's say our range is set to 10 feet, and it triggers the receiver at 10 feet, I can set the delay time to say, do not read that tag for a certain amount of time. Because what we don't want, in a lot of cases, is exactly what was happening when I was standing here. We don't want that door to continually unlock or to continually open. We need it to open once and then let that person get out of the way before it opens again. So our settings on the T2 are here. This is our delay. Position 1 is a 5-second delay. That means tag enters the field, triggers, and it will not read that same tag again for 5 seconds, okay? All the way up to 4 minutes, which I don't think you'd ever need. We were setting ours to 5, so to 40 seconds, position 5 at 40 seconds, and that got us just about as much time as we'd need. Now again, the good thing is if it does miss it, it's gonna read it again depending on where you've set it, okay? You can manage, and this is important, you can manage up to 60 tags simultaneously within the receiver range, which means if you have 60 people just kind of hanging out, it will know to not trigger the relay for the certain amount of time with those 60 tags. As soon as you get more than that, it starts to get a little bit confused. Again, you have the inputs on the board for, and you can see this, your power far left, you've got your data 1, data 0, and ground for your Wiegand or your relay. Now, if you're using the Wiegand, this is very basic, but just to make sure, if you're using the Wiegand, you have to wire the data wires into an access control panel, and then the relay on that access control panel is what's triggering your opening. Our relay is not triggered if you're in Wiegand mode. If you're in standalone mode, that's when you're going to need to use our relay, and that's when you program individually in the transmitters that you want saved, up to 100 transmitters per receiver. Okay. The way that's done is a jumper. Jumper 3 on is in Wiegand mode. Jumper 3 off is in relay mode, okay? Which you can see right here on the board. So there are a couple different settings that you can set, different modes. There is single Wiegand output, repetitive delayed Wiegand output, or relay output. So the first mode is single Wiegand mode. Single Wiegand mode is at setting 0, position 0, and J3 is on, J3 jumper. And like it says, in the case the serial number of the tag is transmitted only once, as soon as the tag enters the detection field, a new transmission will be carried out only if the tag exits from that field. What that means is I come in the range, let's say it's 10 feet, it triggers, it will not reread my tag until I leave the field, that 10 feet. Until I leave, it will not read my tag again. So if you walk in, it opens the door, it is not reading my tag until I leave the area and then re-enter the area. That's mode 1, or single Wiegand mode transmission. Mode 2 is Wiegand delay mode. This is the mode that I talked about where you can say, as soon as I enter the field of range and it triggers the door, it starts a timer. So if I'm in position 4, or 30 seconds, as soon as I enter my 10 feet, which I've set, the door triggers open, then my clock starts, 29, 28, 27. As soon as it gets down to 0, then it will reread my tag. And this is what we have used. The reason I like to use this one is in case it misses the transmission, it will reread your tag and let you back in the door and you don't have to leave the field. So I like that one that we've used. Again, these are active tags. The transmitters have batteries in them. That's how we can get better range. And we have had very few misreads on all of the testing that we've done on this system. We've had good success with it. So that's Wiegand delay mode, where you enter the field, it starts counting down as soon as it reads your tag, and it won't read your tag again for a certain amount of time. So you don't have to worry about your access control panel getting filled up with a bunch of false reads because someone's just standing in front of the door talking to someone and hasn't entered the door yet. Mode 3 is relay mode. This is with the J3 jumper off. In this mode, the receiver works like a normal receiver. So you can program up to 100 people, and then this one is, as soon as you enter the field, it's going to trigger the actual relay on our board, so you don't have to run it through an access control panel. And then it says the same tag can reactivate the relay if it goes out of range for at least 30 seconds. So this one, you have to leave for 30 seconds and then come back in, and it will read your tag. But just giving you all these options on this system, both Wegen or standalone, opens up a lot of doors. Again, the applications, as far as we're concerned, are pretty broad to be able to say to your clients, hey, do you want to just have a transmitter in your pocket and walk around your facility and the doors will unlock automatically rather than scanning a tag? Or do you have a ped gate that you just want people to be able to walk up to and enter? And again, it can tie in with their existing access control because it's just like a fancy card reader. Again, the price point, you're going to pay more because it's an active tag transmitter, so you're going to get better range. The cost of the receiver is very inexpensive compared to something like a UHF reader. So another application I can see is where people will have maybe card readers where it's a 2-foot read range and they stick their arm out of the car to read their badge. This, you could have this on the dash of your car, have that receiver out by the pedestal or by the gate, drive up, stop, or don't stop depending on if it reads your tag, and then just proceed on through. So there's a lot of applications for this. But it is an active tag that transmits every 3 seconds automatically. Battery life of the transmitter is at least 1 year. Okay, that has been tested and confirmed that the battery life is at least 1 year. These are the 2032 batteries, so it's a battery that's extremely common. So you don't have to worry too much about that, but it is a really nice application to be able to approach a door, approach a man gate, whatever it may be, and not have to worry about pulling out a card or a fob or an app or whatever it may be, and this is going to trigger and can track through Wegen mode to the access control panel, or you could put it in standalone mode if they want. So it's a quick webinar. It didn't take us very long, but in my mind, this is one of the more unique products that we've shown in all of our webinars. Again, we're excited about it because the functionality and the features that it gives you and the options that it gives you as the installer. The norm right now has been UHF readers, and this does not replace UHF readers. It is another option on top of the UHF reader for different portions of the building, but it's hands-free access control and hands-free transmitter and receiver, so they don't have to do that. It's using, like I said, it's using 433, so the range is good, and it's pretty reliable. We've seen a lot of success with it. So any questions that you have for me? Okay, I'm going to stick around and answer any questions that you have. But again, we do have these available for sale right now. We have them in stock, and we love it. It's a really good product that opens up a lot of doors. So thanks for your time. I'm going to stick around, and I'll answer any questions that you have.